Hey everybody and welcome back. So we're at COTA for C50 and this is kind of serving as a practice race for the Phone 5 Championship for the Truck Series NIS style. So we're going to do 442 laps with this combo and it's going to be dangerous. It's going to be tough. Very tricky spot. Here, see Mike. We're gonna go off again. Very tricky. So, very interesting thing about the race this Friday with the Bonfire Championship is that there's gonna be no off tracks enforced it for the main race. It will be enforced for Profine. But for the main race, it's not going to be enforced. So it's going to be interesting how that's going to happen. Traps at this track. It's so stupid, but here we are. Let's try it. All right, now we're stupid. We know! Not much I can do about it. All we can do is chip race, trail laps, and see how we do. Get some laps in, keep learning, keep getting better.
Pit road is closed.
We're P22, so we got a long way to go. Anywhere. Let's get into it. We got Nate, who is one of the top drivers for, you know, trying to make it into the Coast Series. He's probably gonna make it to round two of the Road to the Pro Series. He's that good. He's probably gonna be right at the cutoff for the Coast Series. That's how good Nate is. I guess the goal here is to try finish with positive iRacing, especially where we are with the SRF. Thankfully, the parade lap is short here, so it should not take too long to get under the way. But I like the track. I like racing here. I used to hate it when I first started to race here, but I like it. You know, it's challenging, but it's a fun course. It's a pretty good Formula One track. Couple bangers of races in Formula One last couple years, especially between Lewis Hamilton and Matt Verstappen. So pretty awesome races here, and a lot of people show out for it too. They got, I believe, almost 500,000 people showing up for the weekend. For the 3 days weekend for Formula One last year. And I think 180,000 people showed up for the race on Sunday. So it's up there in Annapolis where it's been raced for the most busy racetrack for the weekend. Basically, the goal here is stay straight. There's a lot of people that don't do road racing very often, so we should be okay comparing against them. We're gonna get smoked by a couple good drivers from here, and that's okay. We're here to learn. Let them make a push. You know, we're gonna learn how to deal with this track for this Friday. If we're gonna race 42 laps, we better learn pretty quickly with this track. Yes, there's going to be no off-tracks for the race, but it's still very important for qualifying. The qualifying's going to have off-tracks. It's just how iRacing works. You can't really turn it off. But the race itself, it's going to be unlimited with the off-tracks. So we're going to boost the off-tracks for the lead race here.
Yeah.
buddy. Kind of cut me off there.
Side. Okay, on the left.
remember, not for the Friday race, but for right now. Driven a lot worse, so we overshot that corner. We absolutely had to burn that corner. pick up the changes in the past year or if I actually lost some of the knowledge that I got from last year. So I actually, you know, watched my video for the fastest time and, you know, studied their inputs. Gears or that kind of stuff. Definitely give you a workout for 42 laps this Friday. I will tell you that for sure. I'm gonna leave in second gear this time. Really weary now. It's getting hot on the wheels. So everybody's just sliding around at this point. why there's so many people on the sun back here now. They were like 8 seconds ahead of me, like 2 laps ago. We're absolutely flying by toward the end of this one. Not near fast, but again, this is good. Very promising for the tire wear. We almost went off that corner. This is going to fight damn fight iRacing. It's a pretty good stuff. That was a pretty hard fought race toward the end. Wow. That was a little bit exhausting. Shook out somebody in my first corner there, so let's watch that. But that was probably on me. Let's look. I don't know. That was a very tricky situation, but I probably should have to line up behind the 75 and let him take the inside. But yeah, I got him pretty good. I'm gonna take the blame for it. That's on me. Sorry, 75. If he's still here. He's not here anymore. Shit, well, I'm sorry about that. Very sorry about that. That's on me, 100%. I'm gonna take the blame for that. It's a pretty cool camera angle from the top. But yes, That was on me. I'm gonna take the blame for it. Sorry, buddy. Very, very sorry. And then, later on, things like I started learning, and they're able to not wreck. Ooh. Simpson was there, but he was kind of going in pretty hot. And then, 75's gonna spin out in the grass. He was struggling. And then somebody hurt pretty good, like you get later on. Another person being hurt, pretty get lead stuff. And then got new side-by-side racing going on there with the 17. But we're able to elbow out, try and get through the slow path. Reed's gonna be the shoot. 75 is. He's gonna. Yeah. He's gonna take himself out of that one. And 7's gonna elbow out here. And then he came back at me. But we're able. Kind of push him out there. It's not very easy to race side by side this track. And number 7's trying to catch up to B. And then he hit the curbing. And he's gonna spin out. Plus lap 5. That might be a replay material. That might be screenshot material. Maybe we'll see. In and out, and got number 49. They're popping. Those things are evil, man. I get why they're there, but it's so evil and dangerous. Ooh, that's a tough spot. It's another tough spot. That first corner is very difficult for some of these people. Side-by-side racing going on here. Oh, wow. There's no need for that. Wow. Absolutely no need for that. No need for that. Wow. That's a protest right there. If I'm 3, I'm protesting that one. But I think that gave us 2 spots. So I'm not gonna complain too much. Yeah, and then that's the guy. He was winning the race. He's gonna spin out, but he's still gonna win the race pretty easy. Oh god. Game side by side situation there. 49. The other 49 trying to finish the race at that point. And that's it. That's the race. Let's go to Nate. Holy shit, look at this time. 2:15. Oh, that's why. So the time was pretty quick for him because he started with the finish line. The start finish line was up here. And then the next lap, when everybody's coming back, the start-finish line's back here. So that's why he was pretty quick. So really, this is the fastest lap. So let's watch him. So we're gonna be so he's starting to break before the dirt patch that you see here. where was his braking? So he's stalling his braking at 138 mile per hour, right under the bridge. Get went down to the first gear, and we're gonna see where he was slowing down. All right, he's slowing down at the 200 sign, right before the 200 sign, right past the where the red white striping started. So he was right about 225. Here. He went up to the second and then went down to the first. So let's look at this. Kind of starting to break right when the red white striping is disappearing. It's starting to appear. And we got kicked out. No, we didn't. Here, he's shifting right under that banner. You see that banner above the track? That's when he's starting to break. He blinked it, but all right. Well, we were learning how to be faster. Still got a long way to go. I'm not perfect. I still got a lot to learn. It was not an easy race, but we'll get there. All right. Let's get ready to leave the video, leave the track. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you're enjoying that one. Make sure you like the video, leave a comment, and subscribe. All the usual stuff. So yeah, that always helped me out. We've been having a pretty good month for subscribers and for the views. So thank you very much. Hope you're enjoying that one.